following program is brought to you in living color on NBC.
Good evening. As you know, I've been an advocate of the family-type TV show for many, many years, and that's why I'm so delighted to present tonight's play. It's a brand-new American Family, written by Arnold Schulman. And it has all the warmth, the heart, the sentiment, and the lunacy that goes on in the average American home. And our cast is a very good one. You'll see three wonderful new stars: Michael Constantine, Lou Antonio, and Donna Loren, with guest star Bill Bixby. And believe it or not, that's me. I'll be back in just 1 minute with this very delightful play.
Half a league, half a league, half a league onward. Forward the Light Brigade. 1854, Balaclava, and the Wilkinson sword was there. 1898, Andaman, and the Wilkinson sword was there. 1914, Audrey, and the Wilkinson sword was there. For 200 years, Wilkinson has been putting a fine edge in tempered steel. From this tradition comes the blade that conquered shaving. The Wilkinson stainless steel sword blade. Its heritage demands perfection. The finest blade ever made. You will feel comfort, closeness, smoothness, unsurpassed by any other shaving instrument. Put a sword in your razor. Wilkinson.
To make them, make them.
Did you ever hear the word privacy? I'm getting dressed.
Hey, what time did the playboy get home last night? I bet you 3-4 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah, look how proud he is.
You should have seen this girl he went out with. I told him when she came in to join. She comes in off the street, orders a provolone sandwich.
He starts right in talking to her,
right over the counter. I told him never in a million years. Not with this one. I said, forget it. This beautiful blonde with the dress up to here, but class, you know what I mean? You could tell in a minute. But you know that devil is, he could make out with a movie star when he gets shot.
Yasu. Yasu.
Quick, a number. Quick, a number.
34.
34, 3, 4, 7, A, B, A, D, E, F, G. G, who you know starts with G?
Come on, who you know?
Johnson.
Don't laugh.
Gabriel. Grigori.
Grigori. What's he talking about you for?
You know, you drive me crazy with your superstition.
What do you mean? You stopped sneezing, didn't you? That proves that he's talking about
you. I stopped sneezing because I stopped sneezing.
But you know, he's just a type I like to break his
head. What are you getting mad about?
What do you think? I went some creep thinking about my sister this time of the morning. He's still in bed yet.
I'm going to call up that creep.
Oh, for crying out loud.
Listen, if he don't have no more respect for me, then...
Come on, will you?
Nothing about men, because I'm...
Different.
Oh, fuck. Listen, I started away with looking at you in church on Sunday, right?
Grigori.
That's the G, Father Grigori. I'm the one that told him to do it. I went to light a candle the other day. I thought you were in the mini stretch. I was going to put you in a special prayer. He knows how I worry about you.
Do me a favor, will you? Don't worry so much.
Is my breath bad?
You're eating.
What's the matter?
Nothing. You're losing your hair.
Are you crazy? I got so much hair back there you can't even get your fingers through it.
In the back. How about in front?
There. Where's the mirror?
Hey, would you give me that? I'll get it for you. Here.
Now, why don't we get a decent light in here?
Hey, oh, what's that? That?
Come on.
What
do you got in there?
So, what did you find in there? Are you satisfied? What did you think you'd find in there?
What is that?
A poodle.
Where'd you get it?
I bought it.
Come on. People don't buy things like that. They give them to people. You can't even see the scalp. I got so much hair there.
If you've got anything to say to me, why don't you say it? Well, don't look your famous hole through me.
Get it. You want to tell your own brother?
There's nothing to tell.
Who's the fella?
What fella?
She got a present from a fella.
What kind of present?
A friend of mine, big deal, gave me a present.
So where'd you meet him?
Not even a friend, an acquaintance.
You could have mentioned something.
Where I work. He had it on his keychain. I said it was cute, so he gave it to me.
It's just like that?
Who's the fella? What's his name?
David.
David. David what?
That's right. He's not Greek.
Throw me out of room.
Stand dirty bum leg. One hand on
her. Get in there. All right. Listen, you don't have to tell me everything. Only yes. Oh, no. No, well, this fella. It is. That's you?
Yes.
What?
Twice on the right hand and once on the left.
What is that? Funny? You joke about a thing like that?
When could he touch me? At the water cooler?
Well, what does that mean? You'd like him to?
If I go to the movies with a girlfriend, you follow me. You pick me up outside of work, and when you don't, if I'm 10 minutes later than you think I should be, the both of you turn into a werewolf or something. You won't even let me go to church when they have a dance for crying out loud. You're suffocating me out of my sight.
I only hope Mama, may she rest in peace, didn't hear you say that.
Oh. Well, she got married, didn't she? Maybe I want to get married, too.
Wait a minute. I didn't eat yet. What are you looking? Why does she want to get married?
I'll go down to where she works. Find out who the guy is. I'll break his head.
Moron. That's all you know.
What should I? Wait till it's too late?
Wait a minute. You're not a couple of animals. First, you analyze the situation. Like a person. You look at all the sides. Quiet. Like a person. Then you break his head.
Have all the luck. Some people, everything goes against them. Take me. I went with this very insecure person for 2 years. So I tried to build up his self-confidence. So I used to tell him every 2 minutes how great he was. So finally, I convinced him he's too good for me.
Mom?
You know I can't.
Ever?
Never.
Why?
I told you.
Yes, I know you told me. You keep telling me, but it doesn't make any sense.
I know it doesn't.
Because I'm the boss's son?
No.
Because I'm not Greek.
They won't even let me date Greek boys unless we sit in the living room the whole time with one of them in the next room.
What do you mean, let you? You're old enough, you don't have to listen to anybody.
I know I don't have to. I want to. You know, there's a lot of Greek families that think the same way.
Here? In New York City? In the last half of the 20th century? Huh?
What can I tell you? I'm a nutcase. I don't know.
Look, it's not as if I were asking you to sneak away for a weekend. Just a movie and a cup of coffee.
Well, maybe sometime.
Well, that's a lot better than never.
Miss Canopolis, bookkeeping.
Hey, shut up! Where are you?
Where am I? Where did you call me? I'm right here.
Me hear the adding machine.
Are you losing your mind completely? I mean, when you call me someplace and I pick up the phone where you call me...
You know what I mean. Are you by yourself?
No, there's a man on my desk.
Come on, will you? Don't get around.
He's tall, and he's dark, and guess what? He's Protestant.
All right, don't tell me.
Well, that's what you called me for, isn't it?
No, I didn't call you for that. Called to let you apologize for this morning.
That's very nice of you, Demetrius.
I know you didn't mean this, and why should I let it bother you?
I apologize.
You do?
I knew it. I dropped a dairy product this morning. That means unwelcome news. And all morning, the top of my foot's been itching.
What does that mean?
That is an unpleasant journey.
Hey, one pepperoni with mayonnaise, coleslaw, pickle, and onion.
Pepperoni, the kitchen sink.
I don't know why you don't let me go down there where she works and straighten this guy out.
It's my foot itching. I take the journey.
You did it last time.
Listen, last time, next time. Why can't she's breaking everybody's head that looks at her?
Hey, instead of the pepperoni, can you make that provolone and salami without the anchovies?
86 the pepperoni, one P&S, holy anchovies. Look, there's only one answer. We gotta get her married quick before it's too late. I mean, a girl like that walking around, the way she looks at her age.
To whom married?
I don't know. We'll think of somebody. Vasily's too old. Mikhail's too old. All right, he's too ugly. Listen, I might tell you something. Alexandra the Baker has a nephew coming over soon from Marathea.
No kidding, when?
A couple of weeks, I think.
Hey, buddy?
Why don't you go over there and talk to him? You're a good talker.
Yeah, you're the head of the family. You talk to him. Hey, listen, instead of the provolone, can
you're right. I gotta talk to him.
Make it pepperoni. Great, it's all settled.
You know, I feel better already.
And how about an orange drink to go?
What about Penny?
What about her?
Well, suppose she don't want to get married to this guy.
What's that got to do with it? If I tell her get married, she'll get married.
Fine, so you tell her.
Listen, she'd do it if Papa rest in peace asked her, wouldn't she? I mean, this thing is a question of authority, how you talk to a person. If I give her respect, she'll give me respect. She don't know, I'll break her head.
Hey, dum-dum, I told you, I don't want that.
I'll give you dum-dum eight.
You can take Salem out of the country, but you can't take the country out of Salem.
Salem, the taste that's country soft, country fresh, springtime in every puff.
You can take Salem out of the country, but you can't take the country out of Salem.
Salem, the taste that's country soft, country fresh, wherever you light up.
You can take Salem out of the country, but you can't take the country out of Salem. You can take Salem out of the country, but...
mixed up with this nut.
Honey, hurry up with the blessing. I told Alexander 7:30.
So what'd you have to call a priest for anyway? Couldn't wait a day.
How'd I know he was gonna be late?
They're both a couple of nuts.
This is all we need. Alexander will get you. He's still blessing the house.
Oh, we'll tell him it's my name day or something.
No, no, I'm suspicious he is.
And I'm a bigger nut than both of you. You're humoring, you nuts. But no more. This is the last time, believe me. You're not going to call me every 2 minutes to come and bless your house. Besides, how do you think it looks to Penny? You know what the neighbors think?
What, are they talking about her?
Who thinks? If anybody's thinking anything dirty about my sister.
What would you think if this man comes into the church like a crazy man every few days and lights a big candle for his sister? Would you believe that it's only because she took a little present from a boy?
Look, Father, we know men, right? I mean, if he give her a present, she must have done something, right? Encourage him, right?
And just how much encouragement do you think she gave him, exactly?
Oh, I'm not talking what she did. What she's thinking worries me.
What do you want her to think? She's a healthy young girl. There's such a thing as nature, you know. Biology?
Not my house.
Oh, you are a nut.
All I know, I promised Mama rest in peace. I'd bring her up like a good Greek. And nobody, nothing is going to stop me.
Good Greek. Now, what do you know about Greeks? You ever been to Greece?
Never.
Well, I know right from wrong how they do things.
You mean how they did things 50 years ago? They don't even act like you now in the old country.
Well, what are you talking? Every guy I know feels the same way I do about their sister. Everybody does.
Sure. In my congregation. My congregation. I must have been standing in a dark corner when the archbishop gave out the assignment. Every parish in the country, they have a picnic, a bazaar, a dance in the church hall for the young people to get together, to get acquainted. Me, I have a dance in the church hall on a Saturday night. Only the boys come. The girls, they got locked up in the houses like prisoners.
A little coffee, Father?
Ah, okay, Felicola. You know, Penny, you make the best Turkish coffee in town. You know that?
Ah, thank you. Hey, are you ready to get your head handed to you?
Oh, tonight I show you no mercy. Three, five.
Father, why don't you two go to the movies? On me. Huh?
What's the occasion?
Nothing. You go to the movies. You need an occasion.
Father, you know what's playing? The Bible.
I read the book.
Why don't you go ahead and do your good to get some air?
Some air in the movies?
The way to the movies.
You'd never guess in a million years they're trying to get rid of us, would you?
I wonder who they're trying to get rid of, you or me?
The both of you. Hmm?
What for?
Not just a little business.
So why didn't you say so? Was that all your sneaky maneuvering? I'll go get my coat.
You all right if I finish my coffee?
Hello, how are you? Come in.
Alexandre! How are you? 7:30, right on the dot. Stephanie, a little ouzo, a little baklava, which we just bought.
Why don't you eat your own merchandise?
McDonald's, Alexandre. We missed you at the meeting Tuesday.
Sit down. You like ouzo or maybe a little retina better? Stephanie, a little retina.
Well, I'm ready. Let's go.
Okay. Alexandre, I understand your nephew is coming over from Marathea next week. Anxious to meet him.
Father, you're going to be late for the movies.
No. I think we ought to stick around here, Father. This little business we're going to discuss, you might find it interesting.
Did I miss something?
All right. You want it on the line? You're right. We're going to talk it over, you and the nephew. And we're going to do this thing right, the way Papa, rest in peace, would want it. I don't want to hear a word out of you.
I think I better be going.
Yeah, stick around here. I want you to see with your own eyes what I have to go through around here.
Relax. I think I know what you have to go through.
You're trying to marry me off without even the courtesy of letting me know, even. What do you think, we're in the dark ages?
Listen, I don't have to leave here. You and you are embarrassing.
You are the
my congregation.
Quiet! Stop bothering him! Will you sit down before I knock it out? Now you go in the other room.
Are you kidding? I wouldn't miss it for anything.
Oh, come on. Well, yeah, let's do it right. You're not supposed to be here.
Forget it. I'm not moving. If I'm going to be put on the marketplace, I'd like to find out what I'm worth at least.
Okay. You want it that way? Fine. Excuse my sister. American. Hey, this nephew of yours is a young boy, right? 22, 3 years old?
Now, I guess he's here on a tourist visa like everybody else, right? That means he's got 6 months to get married, right? He wants to stay in the country. All right. Who is he going to marry?
Well, the two Palomas sisters.
No, it's not funny.
What, Fat Helen Fanny?
No. On our side, we're given not only citizenship papers for the boy, but beautiful girl. Never been sick a day in her life. I spent a fortune on a deal.
All right, I'll throw it in. Just to get the little couple started, I'll chip in a little nest egg, say $2,000-$3,000. Get them started.
Thanks a lot. It's great to know what you're worth.
What are you, mad? What'd I say?
I'll find my own husband.
November.
Oh, wait a minute. Where are you running? Come on, what's the matter? Oh, she's just a young girl. You know how they are. What did she do that for? Now she went and ruined everything.
Is holding out for term.
Alexandra.
You got your health,
it's
a good morning. For me, another day.
How's your mother? Nice. Where's Alexandra? How are you? How are you feeling?
She says she don't want you, your sister.
She's doing. Oh, Mrs. Jimenez, you still...
Listen, I give you my word, head of the family.
And you chip in, you were saying... $5,000.
I was saying $3,000.
For $3,000, I don't need your family. I can get the Pontos family.
Oh.
He was talking to me yesterday. The old man himself, Mr. Pontos. About his oldest granddaughter, Calliope.
All right. So suppose I chip in the $4,000 I was saying.
$5,000 I was saying.
What are you going to give? I mean, that's only fair, right? What I give, you give, dollar for dollar. What do you think you got here? Some kind of a bargain? We're talking about a boy right off the boat. How do we know he probably can't even speak English? We don't have no job. We don't know what he looks like. Does he have a brain in his head? Huh? I mean, all we know, he comes from a good family. Which I grant you, that's important. But... think you got the only good family? I mean, I'll tell you the truth. We made up our minds. The girl's not married by the time she's 21. We take a little trip over to the old country. We'll look around. We'll find somebody. So, don't think you got me in no box here.
You put up $5,000, we'll put up $3,000.
Oh, boy. What makes you think that I should put up more...
Bring him by my house Sunday, okay? For dinner?
5 and 3.
All right. 5 and 3.
Squirm. To writhe. To twist. To wriggle. Squirm may be great for some things, but for tires, it's terrible. You can't see it, but tires squirm and twist and wriggle. So before before you know it, the tread is almost gone. Now, Goodyear bites squirm. With a polyglass tire. The only tire with a polyester cord body and a fiberglass cord belt. Polyglass. Polyglass holds the wide tread firm, so it squirms less, wears less. See the difference after 18,500 miles. Polyglass can give you up to double the mileage of our best-selling tires. So forget wriggle. Resist twist. Bite squirm. Get up to double the mileage with a polyglass tire. Only Goodyear makes it.
This half of the Danny Thomas Hour is...
You're about to see something new in draperies.
Good evening, Lucille.
Burl Therm from Burlington House. Burl Therm, the richest lining ever applied to a drapery fabric. It keeps the warmth in...
It's warm in here.
And the cold out. It muffles noises.
There's something behind those drapes.
And surprise. These elegant lined draperies are as washable as little curtains.
We at Burlington House stand behind every drape we sell you.
Do look into Burl Therm draperies.
Do you know what time it is? They're going to be here any minute. I'm going to break this door down.
What took you so long?
10 minutes. I ran all the way.
I called you half an hour ago.
You're going to stand here arguing about how long it took me and tell me why you called me. What's the emergency? What is it like?
She won't come out.
She's in her room. What time are they bringing the boy over?
2:30.
Now. It's 2:30 now.
My water's boiling.
Hey, that smells good.
Oh, you made moussaka, too. You must have been up all night cooking.
Bother your mind. It's getting late.
All right. I'm thinking on how to handle this.
Well, she needs. I should break down that door and give her a shot.
Moron. That's all he knows. Hit people.
Well, the two of you stop yelling, huh? All right. I'll try to talk to her.
Can you hear the way they laugh at me all over town? She don't come out of there.
Penny? Penny, it's Father Gregory. Let me talk to you for a minute. Look, dear, I know exactly how you feel, but sometimes if you, even if you don't feel like it, it would kill you to talk about it. Only talk. That's all I'm asking. Let me in a minute. Penny? Hello, Wall.
How are you, Feeling? This is Father Gregory. I always walk around talking to Feeling in the Wall.
I'm telling you right now, before you waste your breath, I'm not getting out of this room.
What do you got there, milk?
Yeah. What are you doing?
How can I give you milk if your glass is full?
All right, I'll listen, but you won't convince me.
Convince you to do what?
Anything.
Now, let's look at the situation. Now, what do they want for you, your brothers? To see you happy, make sure you don't get hurt. Look, I'll tell you the truth, that they're very peculiar, your brothers. To put it plain, they're a couple of nuts. But they're not completely wrong.
How can you say that?
Do me something. I happen to think that little old-fashioned matchmaking is not such a terrible thing. At least you've got sensible people dealing with the facts in a sensible way. So what do you want? This business of love, to spend the rest of your life with a boy because he makes you laugh, or you like the color of his eyes? To me, that's just as crazy. Maybe even more so.
You mean you want me to marry this boy? No matter what he looks like, just like that?
Who said marry? Look, the odds are 50 to 1 on any bookie in town that this boy is a disaster the way he looks. But so what? If we had to go by looks, none of us would make it the average man. What I want to tell you is that you'll meet the boy. All right, so he looks terrible to you. So what do you got to lose? Maybe later you'll laugh about it. Now, is that such a terrible thing to put you through?
So humiliating.
What is? For girls to meet fellas? Penny. Maybe you won't want them as a husband. But you might find a new friend. Is that so bad?
I knew I shouldn't have let you in this room.
Don't tell me I convinced you.
You always do. Anybody can. That's my whole trouble. I'm too wishy-washy.
What are we going to do? You moron, go let him in. You can't let him stand out there. Come in. May I take your coat?
Pussy
stick. Hello. Go right in. Hello. May I take your coat?
Hello. How are you? Thank you.
Hello, Alexandre.
How are you?
Stephanie, a little loser. We're going to have a little
drink. I'm
young.
Everything back in the old country
as
well. Pleased to meet you.
How do you do?
Hi.
Sit down. What are we standing?
Yes, let's sit down.
All right. Father, sit down over here.
Thank you. This is Alexander. Why don't you sit here?
Mrs.
I'll sit next to you, ladies.
All right. No, sit here. Sit over here.
I am sitting here.
Why don't you sit over there? You'll be more comfortable.
I like it here.
Why don't you let the young couple sit here together? You sit over there.
I am sitting where I am sitting.
Listen, Yanni, why don't you sit here? That's it. Sit here. Bravo.
Where is the girl?
Oh, she's getting dressed. She said to tell you, excuse me, her, that she's been cooking since 5 o'clock in the morning. Do you see how she can cook, and not just American either? You know what she made today? Dolmades, tara, musalata, musaka, everything special for you to make you feel at home. You like musaka?
Musaka?
Yeah, but maybe they call it different now. That's with the eggplant and the meat, and the eggplant and the meat and your bacon.
We don't have this in Greece.
What are you talking about? That's an old Greek dish.
Well, there's nothing unusual about that, individual. Thank you. In the old country, as compared to here, there are many dishes here we make that they can't make there simply because they don't have the ingredients.
In Athens, where I used to work.
Oh, here she is, Penelope. Now, Penelope, you know, Mrs. Alexandros, and Mrs. Dimitriou over here, and this is Yanni. Yanni, this is Penelope.
How do you do?
Sit down. Yeah, over here.
Have you had a chance to see anything of New York yet?
Only from the airport and where we live.
Boy, is it like you thought it would be?
I didn't think too much how it looks. But yes, I think so. From the pictures in the magazines, the cinema. So yes, I think so, what I thought so. How it looks.
Ah, isn't that nice how the young people get along?
What? What are your plans for the future? Can you do anything?
I beg your pardon.
In that hotel where you work, the nonsense. Where'd you work? In the kitchen?
No.
Ah, that's all right. We can teach you. I can always use an extra pair of hands. Once you get in a family, they won't.
I'll
get it.
Watch it.
No.
Don't.
What are
you
doing?
Why
don't you get out of there? Leave it. Stephanie, get a broom. Don't stand there. Hey.
Wonderful. Break a glass. Your wish will come to pass.
You ought to be in the State Department.
What's the matter with you?
Excuse me.
Don't ask me why they built these balconies. It's over with what? The traffic on 8th Avenue? Who needs all the cars and the ugly buildings across the street?
Could I talk to you?
Please.
Excuse me. I'd like to be very honest. It would be better if I did not come here today to your house. My uncle told me, come here. Meet a girl. I like her. So I said, okay. But not to get married. Excuse me. I would do anything to get my papers, to stay here. But there is one thing I couldn't do. When I take a woman for my wife, I will not take her just to get my papers. Excuse me if I make you embarrassed. You won't think I don't like you. I like you. I think I like you. Who can say for sure? I do not know you. But I like you. And your face. And I like you. How you look at me.
I like you too.
Dimitri, first thing I'm going to write to is to his grandfather in Bolova. You know, Bolova. To make the arrangements, you know. And so, yeah.
Well, you mean Marabella? You mean he's not. Hey. Hey, where's he from? Bolivar or Marabella? He told me Marabella. Don't tell me now Bolivar.
Why don't we start dinner? It's getting late.
What is he trying to pull here?
I
know your family for 2,000 years. They come from Maratea, like my family.
Si, comes from Bolivar.
Is your nephew on your side?
On Maratea. I said it the day you got married, and I say it again. I'd rather see you dead in your grave than in the arms of a man from Maratea.
You! Get out of my house! Where is that guy? Hey,
hey, you!
Get out of my house! We don't marry nobody. I think it's in my family.
Dimitri!
What kind of
a... Wait a minute! He don't come from Bolivar. They moved to Maratea 20 years
this whole family, Moret.
But they came from Bolivar.
No, get him out the Bolivar. Get the cloaks. We're leaving.
But, Mrs. Diamond.
Oh, under Maratella.
Then, don't you ever come to my house again. You hear that? The boss, my boy. Get him out of here.
You stay here tonight and sleep with your friends. The old bunch of you in Maratella.
Imagine the nerve of those people trying to pull a trick like that.
I can't take it anymore.
Hey, can you imagine what Papa would say?
Penny.
I let you marry a man from Bolivar.
I am packing up right now. But good, I'm getting out of here.
Where are you going, witch? What are you mad at me for? He's the one that's lying.
Living here with you is like drinking vegetable soup through a handkerchief. Can you live on that? I want the vegetables, too.
What does she want? Vegetables?
I want to make my own steaks for a change.
You want vegetables? I'll make you vegetables.
You know, you're really a stupid meatball. You know
you
that?
Start with me.
You had a nickel.
I don't need to hear that kind of talk from you.
Stop it, the both of you.
He's mad, she's mad.
I'm not mad.
You're not leaving.
Not because I'm mad.
Well, what are you leaving for?
I'll call you. Goodbye. Goodbye.
In church.
Wait a minute. Penelope, where are you going to sleep tonight?
I don't know. I got to call somebody.
Who?
A friend.
What friend? You're not going nowhere.
Leave her go.
What are you on her side now?
She wants to go. She's got the right.
She's got no right to put the family name in the garbage. What are people going to say? Wait a minute. Don't you care about the family?
I know what I feel about the family, and I don't care what people say.
What's the matter with you? You crazy? I let her go, for I shall have locked her in her room. She'll come back, won't she, Father? Honey, you.
Now what's the matter?
What happened?
She walked past here, didn't she?
So what?
If a girl walks over a broom, sure as life, she'll be a mother before she's a wife.
Okay, everybody. Take off your shoes and socks. That's right. Ready? Now, go outside and play on the carpet. Lee's new outdoor carpet. Water-loving, foot-loving, outdoorable leaves. It's tough, but it's cozy. Made to go barefoot on. And all the colors are just a shade mad. So come out barefoot, boys and girls, on our Get Away From It All and Home Sweet Home carpet. A very interesting carpet. Come what may.
That's right. Of course. She'll come back.
Listen, I bet you she's back in the apartment right now waiting for us. If she comes back, I'll tell you how we act.
Nothing happened.
We won't even mention it.
Not a word.
Why?
Make her feel bad?
Lesson, that's what we ought to.
She learned her lesson.
How do you figure?
came back, didn't she?
That's right.
She won't come back.
Thing you can think of that she could do for spite.
Well, she wouldn't do it, huh?
You don't know women. I picked up a girl once on the street. Beautiful girl. Park Avenue. She'd never done a thing like that before in life. She just wanted to, I don't know, prove something. Her independence.
You're driving me crazy, you know that? You know who I bet she'd call up? That guy where she works, give her a pool. Come on. Let's find him.
How?
We know his name.
Do we?
David.
That's a big help.
I tell you what. Go on the phone. Go to the phone and call the office. They gotta have a night a watchman and tell them. That you're the office manager and that you're looking for a guy, David. He's in there. Guys in the bookkeeping and tell him look on the doors and the records and the in every place and something, you know.
Oppa!
Get over there before it's too late.
Nowhere. She calls me.
Wait, now you said I could use this place tonight.
He sure heard that. All right, that's it. Come on. Out.
Yeah,
out.
Give me this.
Can I at least keep the magazine?
Please, but don't.
You David McDowell?
What do you want?
Do you work for Glover, McFadden, Fenner, and Stone?
Yes. What can I do for you?
Where is he? Look how he's got the place.
She didn't get here yet.
Oh, champagne. That sneaky music.
What are you, a millionaire?
Oh, what do you want? Why?
I'll tell you who we are.
Hit him. Don't hit him.
Why should I convince him? I'll hit him.
No, convince me.
How can we convince him? See, we can't convince him.
Well, you could start by telling me what you want to convince me about.
I think you're right. We better hit him.
Wait a minute. Look, the whole trouble is that she's so mad at us and that we butt in all the time. So if we break it up this time, she'll just call him again. Or somebody else. But if she gives him the brush, then she can't be mad at us, can she?
Stupid. That's the first good idea you ever had in your life.
You tell her that you don't like her, you can't stand her, she's a big joke to you, you don't want her.
Yes, sir.
In your own words, of course.
We're going to be in that door there. Can we hear with that door closed?
We can hear if he talks loud enough.
Talk loud enough.
like you. I don't want you. I don't need you. And you're a joke to me. Did you hear me? How'd I do?
Beautiful.
Oh, well, I'm really glad, because you should have seen the look on poor Gloria's face when she met.
Gloria? Who's Gloria?
Who's Gloria? Don't speak to me. I want to shoot myself.
You want to borrow an egg? Thanks, not right now, thanks.
Oh, how about some toast? You can use my bread until you go shopping.
No, I'm not very hungry. Thanks.
Oh, you can have the top shelf. I'll take the bottom one.
Fine.
Good fences make good neighbors.
What are you doing home?
Tonight's my poker night.
Oh, aren't you going?
No, I don't feel much.
What can I do? You're crazy, but I love you.
Blonde hair. It's a man's hair.
Moron, what are you starting up again? Get out of here.
Listen, from now on you can do what you like. You're not going to butt in. I give you my word.
It's late. I'll wash up and get supper started, okay?
Woman's up to something. She puts on Cameo's Little Nothing. The Little Nothing is just a little stocking by Cameo. It's made of Super Cantree's nylon. It wears the way no Cantree stocking ever did. And it fits like no stocking at all. When a woman puts on the Little Nothing by Cameo, better watch it, fella.
Next week, we're bringing you a show you asked for. It's The Wonderful World of Burlesque.
My stars are Wayne Newton, Mickey Rooney, and wonderful Carol Channing. And, of course, some surprise guests, too. Be sure to be with us for the wonderful world of burlesque.
This half of the Danny Thomas Hour.